Well, of course, there have been some people who have argued in the past that being profitable, environmentally and socially conscious are just not, should be mutually exclusive. But our next guest is here to tell us how and why organisations can and should embed sustainability into their company culture. And Bruta, thank you very much for joining us. Now, for people who aren't familiar with your background, you were a sustainability professor turned social entrepreneur. Essentially, you help companies become more sustainable. So tell me, what are some of the initiatives that you've put into action?
Sure, thank you very much for having me first. And in terms of making a business more sustainable, so for example, what I do, I have been doing making buildings more sustainable. That's where I started my career. So sustainability practitioner for a built environment sector. Now I moved on to corporate sustainability or business sustainability, where we strategize how a building, entire organization or business can build their sustainability journey.
Okay, so give us some examples.
Yeah.
You know, is it about changing our light bulbs? Is it about recycling?
So for example, the company could, in terms of reducing energy consumption, they could maybe retrofit their office and reduce their energy consumption of the office. Or they could, when it comes to sustainability, it's not just one part, which is environment, also the social part. So are they having equal pay, or are they employing enough a female workforce in their office? So that will be part of their sustainability strategy. And also we will go into details of their supply chain. How can they reduce their energy consumption or carbon footprint by implementing sustainable supply chain into their business? So there are these different aspects of sustainability which we could basically input to making that business more sustainable. And most importantly, the business should bring sustainability to core of their business. Shouldn't be just the marketing or promotional activity, because then we call it greenwashing.
I was going to ask you a quick question about being sustainable and sustainability. Has that evolved over the years? Because what was sustainable and being a sustainable company 5-10 years ago, maybe not so much these days. How do you reinvent the best practice going forward?
Yeah, I would touch a very important point here, that let's talk about 2021. An IPCC report came a few weeks back mentioning that we have already, our global Earth's temperature already has reached around 1.3 degree centigrade. So global warming is very, very there. We can see it. Scientists have found out, figured it out. So what we used to do a few years back, maybe a bit of CSR or a bit of corporate social responsibility or few things, recycling here and there, it's not enough. Now we have to act very concretely, because the same report said that reaching 1.5 degree centigrade or reducing Earth's temperature to 1.5 degree centigrade, we have now only 50% chances.
Let's be honest though, for the average person, why does it really matter to them? But particularly I think when we look business-wise, companies say, well, you know, that's great, we want to go green, but it's going to cost us. You know, we have to balance profits.
Correct.
We're still a business. We still have to make
Correct.
Money. So
Correct.
What, you know, what is the way around that? How do you make it matter to businesses?
Most importantly for businesses, I would say, if you look at all sort of businesses around the world, where their raw material is coming from, either it's from nature. So whoever is manufacturing something, they get something from the nature. So we call it natural capital. Or service industry need people, which is human capital. Now, if the Earth's temperature is changing and global warming is reaching, then we will not have enough natural resources or nature's capital for businesses to actually source it and then create something and sell it. So businesses definitely need to think about sustainability to be able to survive themselves, let's say after 20, 30 years or after that. So it's very essential. Yeah.
So going forward, what are businesses really now looking to aim towards, to being sustainable and offering a sustainable kind of eco structure as their business model?
Absolutely. So businesses need to reinvent, and all you're hearing is rewire or regenerate and all those sort of things. So we have to figure out the way of doing business, which we will still keep having the economic benefits in place, economic development in place, however, within the planetary boundary. So we are not exploiting natural resources, or we are not exploiting human resources. And within the planetary boundary, businesses need to figure out their way of doing business.
Yeah. Well, Rita, we've run out of time for the moment. Thank you very much for joining us here this morning
at
Studio Expo. And we'll see you again soon. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Well, nations around the world are